element structure. And C++ is the mother, is the creator of the object-oriented programming structure. So if you want to be master on the object-oriented programming structure, for that, the best language you have to prefer, not Java, not Python, you have to go for the C++. It's my personal suggestions, because I am the trainer of C++. Also, I am the trainer of Python. So I know what is the jam in C++ availability. Right? It's a very powerful language. See, C++, after completion of C and C++, in third, you have to focus on data structure concept. These steps you have to follow compulsory, man. First, see C++ data structure. In fourth, you have to focus on Java programming language. After completion of these four things, in fifth, we have to focus on another programming language concept having the name Python. After completion of Python, some other knowledges are required compulsory. In sixth, compulsory, you have to focus on database mechanism, database skills required compulsory, because that may be any kind of project. That may be a small project, that may be a medium scale project, or that may be a larger project. For every kind of project, database knowledge is required compulsory. If you are developing the project through C or C++ or Java or Python in the back end, database is required compulsory. That may be SQL database, Oracle database, some new database introduced in the market working through NoSQL techniques like MongoDB, right? So that database concept knowledge is compulsory required. After completion of these six things, on seventh, you have to focus on the concept of operating system. So what the operating system I listed here, this is not based on Windows operating system. This is based on Linux operating system. So if you want to be a very good software developer, for that, these are seven things are required compulsory. After that, if you have some interest on designing, for that, you can go for the HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So development is a different process. Designing is a different process. So what are the things I listed here? This is not as for the designing process. This is as for the development process. To be a very good software developer, these seven things are required compulsory. And in this way, you have to execute. Right? Yes, sir. Acha, from these seven things, if I will focus something extra in this discussion, which operating system I listed, we have to get some knowledge regarding the Linux operating system. Compulsory knowledge is required, because as a Java developer, as a Python developer, as a C developer, or as a C++ developer, you have to work in this Linux operating system in the corporate sector. If you are a .NET developer only, you have to work with Windows. Except .NET developer, if you are working on C, C++, Java or Python, in maximum corporate, Linux is preferable. For that, different kind of story is available. If we will get some time, why corporate using Linux, we will discuss on that. So operating system is required compulsory to implement a program, but operating system is not a programming language. Listen carefully, man. Operating system is required to implement a program, but operating system itself is not a programming language. Like that, database is not a programming language. I'm just identifying which one in this list we can consider as a programming language and which are not the programming language in this list. Operating system is not a programming language. Like that, database is not a programming language. In database, basically, what are the things you are going to tell? You are going to learn how to create a table, how to insert a record how to update a record, how to fetch a record, and how to delete a record. Basically, in database, the most demanded operation is what? CRUD. In corporate sector, in the software industry, if you want to step on, so you have to acquainted with some different kinds of terminology. CRUD operation. Basically, maximum time in this database, we are implementing CRUD, CRUD, CRUD operation. C stands for create, R stands for retrieve, U stands for update, D stands for delete. Maximum, these are four operations we have to target through database. So this create, retrieve, update, delete, for this operation, some dedicated queries are available. So it's a collection of queries. Database is not a programming language. Database is a collection of queries for CRUD operation. Create, retrieve, update, and delete operations. In this list, yes, Python is a programming language. Java is a programming language. C++ is a programming language having some protocols, having some set of rules. C is a programming language, but data structure is not a programming language. Listen carefully. Data structure is not a programming language. Data structure is the most important concept in this list. If you want to crack a good companies like Google, Amazon, Mindtree, for that best companies, data structure knowledge is compulsory. We can target the data structure knowledge with the help of C programming language or C++ programming language. We can implement the data structure through Java. We can implement the data structure algorithm through Python. So data structure is nothing but it's the algorithms. And that algorithm we can apply, we can implement with the help of any programming language. I'm expecting this list is very much clear to all of you. And in this list, which are not the programming language and what are the programming languages are available, that concept is also clear to us. So in data structure, basically, what are the content we are going to cover? In data structure, you have to focus on stock mechanism, queue data structure, stock data structure, queue data structure, tree data structure, graph data structure, searching mechanism, and sorting mechanisms. So these are the content you are going to learn.
Sir, are you sharing a screen? Because screen is not visible.
Okay, I think I not shared that one, man. After this much number of time you were telling that one, maybe I forgot to share my screen. So I think is that required to repeat? I think up to it nothing is started. So what should I say? Desktop?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Enter screen. See. I'm not acquainted with this Microsoft team. Basically, I'm taking the classes on Google Meet. That's why I just forgot to share my screen there. So can you please confirm if my screen is visible now?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, they hear how much content I written for you, man, but I not shared that screen for you. Okay, no problem. So I think it's not a very complicated content to again discuss. It's the only list, man. Right, yes, sir. So the seven things are required compulsory: C, C++, data structure, Java, Python, database, and operating system. And from the seven things, we know that which operating system we have to focus. We have to focus on the discussion of Linux operating system. Database, you can choose any database that may be SQL, or that may be Oracle, or that may be Mongo, that may be Teradata. Different kinds of database are available. That may be SQLite. SQLite database is also available there. Any database you can choose to learn the concept of database there. So operating system is not a programming language like that. Database is not a programming language. In database, basically, what the operation we are going to focus, it's called CRUD operation. I think already we discussed on that. Maybe the screen was not visible, but my sound was clear to you, right? Yes, we know CRUD. CRUD means create, retrieve, update, and delete operations. Yes, Python is a programming language. Java is a programming language. C++ is a programming language. C is a programming language, but data structure itself is not a programming language. Data structure is some algorithms. We can implement the data structure algorithm with the help of any programming language, like that may be C, that may be C++, that may be Java. We can target the data structure algorithm through Python also. So in data structure, what the algorithm basically we are going to study, that will be stock data structure, queue data structure, tree, graph, searching, and sorting. Only these are the contents that are available, man. In data structure, in sorting, different kinds of sortings are available. In searching, different kinds of searchings are available. So for different searching, different algorithms will come. Different time complexity will come, different space complexity will come. So for that discussion, you have to get the clear visualization on the data structure also. I'm expecting this list is very much. Yes. Any message for me? Or by mistake, your sound was activated. Should I move forward? Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
These seven things are required compulsory, and we got the clear visualization from these seven things. So, what are the programming languages we have to deal, and what are the things are available which we can consider as a? It's not a programming language. I'm expecting this path, this process, this discussion is very much clear to all. So you have to follow these steps compulsory. So C++, in these four programming language, if you will ask me, sir, C, C++, Java, and Python, from these four programming language, if you will personally ask me, sir, which programming language you will choose as the best programming language? Without any confusion, I can say this one. From this four programming language, the most important programming language is C++. If I am telling C++, with C++, your C is also included. Because if you will learn C++, there is a small definition is available regarding C++. C++ is the superset of C. Means whenever you are going to learn C++, during that C++ discussion, your C discussion will be completed also. That's why we can say C++ is nothing but it's a superset, you know, I think mathematical terminology, superset of C. Means all the content of C is valid in C++. Every C program is a C++ program, but reverse is not valid. Every C++ program is not a C program. So the most important programming language, that's not Python exactly, that's not Java exactly. The most important conceptual programming language, that's C++. As a trainer here, I am providing the training on Python programming language. That's most advanced programming language. Also, I am providing the training on C++. That the most core programming language. If your core is clear in advanced, nothing is there. Once you got the confidence in the core programming language, you can enjoy the advanced programming language in a very few times also. It's not required to spend more time if the concept, if the basic, if the base is clear. So as a phraser, It's a request to all of you, don't focus on the high level programming language directly. Spend sufficient time on the base, create the stage, create the base in the proper way. Then only you can enjoy, you can perform any kind of dance in Java and in Python with efficiency. Right, yes. So can you please confirm, is that step, is that discussion is clear to all of you, man? You can communicate through group chat. Also, you can activate your voice. So if I will access all the voice, I cannot listen all the voice simultaneously. But if you want to communicate with me, all the student, maximum student, they can use the group chat. It's a requirement. I can move to the comfortable zone after getting your response. So can you please give some response here through your group chat? Is that discussion is clear to all of you? Is that career path is clear to all of you, man? Previous time, I will share the screen. Without sharing the screen, I started the discussion. Okay. Beautiful, man. Please focus. Aj, you told that you are very much newer to this programming language concept. So I have some different plan for you. So I am just updating that plan. I'm going for some basics program. I'm not going for the advanced program. Maybe it will be confusing to you. I got some message that I'm reading that one. Linux wise and not Windows or other ways. So what are the other ways, man? Maybe Linux. I think you know regarding the Ubuntu. You know regarding the Kali. So Ubuntu based on the Linux operating system. Kali based on the Linux operating system. Main thing is what your man. If you are a beginner, definitely this kind of questions will come. Android is based on the Linux operating system. So we can say basically two major operating system available in the market. One is Linux operating system, another is the Windows operating system. These are most popular operating system available in the market. Whenever the doubts you are getting, man, not report to worry. I know that you are fresher now. So I can expect any question from your side. Whatever the doubts you have to share with me and I will explain that one. Listen carefully. As per the doubts what you submitted, sir, why we will focus on Linux operating system? It's a very simple thing, man. It's a business thing, sir. Yes, listen carefully. Maybe you don't know regarding that process. Maybe you know also. Let's cross checking that one. Actually, I think maximum student having their own laptop. Yes or no, man? And in your laptop, what the operating system by default you got, I think, sir, when we buy our laptop, in our laptop, that was Windows operating system. Achha, main thing is what your man, your laptop, if you will go to buy a laptop, some laptop is available with DOS operating system also. DOS operating system also. Same configuration. Is available with the DOS operating system. Same configuration is available with Windows operating system. Same configuration, maybe you are going to get with a Linux operating system. It depends on the seller, that system is available in the store or not. Listen carefully. Whenever you are going to buy some laptop, same configuration, having the same RAM size, having the same processor, having the same bus, same configuration, maybe you are going to get in DOS, maybe you are going to get in Windows, maybe you are going to get the Linux version also. Maybe you are going to get the Linux version also. Listen carefully, man. Forget about this DOS operating system. Another thing is what here, man? Maybe you identified these things in the market or not. Whenever you are buying a laptop with Windows operating system, let the cost you are providing 45,000 of that laptop. What are the configuration you are going to buy? For the Windows, you are providing the cost of 45,000. If I will buy the same configuration with Linux operating system, the cost will be 40,000. Will be 40,000. Listen carefully. The same configuration laptop, if you are going to buy with Windows, you are going to give 45,000. Same configuration laptop, if you are going to buy with Linux operating system, you are going to provide less than 5,000, 40,000. Sir, why? Maximum time students are going to ask, sir, why? Sometimes students are thinking that maybe Windows laptop is more powerful than the Linux operating system laptop, but no. Same configuration is available, same power is available. Listen carefully, man. Main thing is what here, man. Windows is not open source. Windows is not open source. Open source. But Linux is open source. We don't know, sir, what is the meaning of open source. Listen carefully, man. Windows is not open source, but Linux operating system is open source. Means how the Linux operating system is developed. Definitely, man. Linux operating system is working behind that. Some program is working there. Windows operating system is working behind that. Some program is working there. Sir, how the Linux operating system is developed, how this Windows operating system is developed, behind this Windows operating system, behind this Linux operating system, some dedicated device driver, some dedicated system program. I think this terminology you got acquainted in the previous class on the C seminar. Device driver, system program, right? Yes. In Windows operating system, some dedicated device driver system programs are running. In Linux operating system, some dedicated device driver system programs are running here. But Windows programs, the program which is implemented to target the Windows operating system is not open source. The program which is implemented to target the Linux operating system is open source. So now we got another confusion. What is the meaning of open source? What is the meaning of not open source? Very simple, man. The program which is developed to target Linux operating system, if you want to get that program, if you want to get the source code, you can download directly from the internet. That source code is not hidden. That source code is open. You can download that source code. You can update that source code as per your requirement. Some dedicated kernels, kernel program, device driver program, system program, whatever the program is implemented to target this Linux operating system, all the source code is available in the internet. Just download and install. There is no problem. But Windows is not like that. If you want to enjoy this Windows operating system, for that you have to buy Windows 10, Windows 7, Windows 8. Forget about the pirated version. It's a crime if you are using a pirated version and you are telling, sir, I'm using Windows without any cost, then you are doing some crime here. Basically, Windows based on payment basis. If you want to work with Windows operating system, for that we have to spend 5,000 rupees to buy a dedicated Windows operating system. But for the Linux operating system, it's completely free. Just a download, install. Nobody is going to claim a single paisa to use this Linux operating system. Are you getting that statement? Listen carefully, man. Later, I have a company, some group of teams, group of members are working in my organization. Sir, later, how many members? 100 members, 100 programmers working in my organization. If I will buy Windows operating system, for each window I will provide 5,000 rupees. For 100 members, I think the budget will come near about some more amount budget is required. 5,000, what the cost is required, man? 5,000 into 5,000 into 100. I think near about 5 lakhs. Near about 5 lakhs budget is required if you are going for the Windows operating system. If you will go for the Linux operating system without a single paisa, without a single rupee, you can enjoy the Linux operating system without any problem also. So in the point of business, as the business point of view, at the business point of view, which operating system you are going to prefer? At the business point of view, which operating system you are going to prefer? Can you please give some response through your group chat? At the business point of view, which operating system? At the business point of view, which operating system you are going to prefer? Whatever the discussion we implemented, as per that, you have to give the response, man. Beautiful, sir. We got the clear visualization why corporate, why industries are choosing the Linux operating system above the Windows operating system. So can you please give some response? Is that discussion is clear to all of you, man? Yes, some other question I got here, we will discuss on that. Not required to worry. But before that, is that discussion is clear to all of you? What is the meaning of open source? Yes, the source code is available at the end user. We are the user of the operating system. Sir, Linux source code, we can get, we can manipulate, we can create a different kind of Linux operating system also. But Windows source code is not open to all. They are just providing the machine code. They are not providing the source code there. Different terminology is there. Maybe it's creating some confusion, sir. What is the meaning of source code? What is the meaning of machine code? What is the meaning of byte code? If the time will allow, we will move in that discussion also. Not required to worry. Listen carefully. Moving forward in this discussion, we got the clear visualization, sir. Why I listed the operating system Linux, why I'm not promoting Windows operating system, why I am promoting Linux operating system, it's very much clear to all of them. Right? Yes. Next up. Software, whatever the discussion we implemented, we know. So first we have to focus on C, second we have to focus on C++, next we have to focus on data structure. Next, we have to focus on Java. Next, we have to focus on Python. Next, we have to focus on the database mechanism. And next, we have to focus on the operating system. That's our Linux operating system. It's very easy, not so much complicated. Now I am working with Linux operating system. All right, yes. Another student given some questions there. Let I'm just reading, I not read previously. What the question is there. So Ms. Kumar given some question here. Being an upcoming electrical engineer, which language and other technology skills I should prefer on? I think in the electrical engineer, you have to focus on C++ programming language, but still, you know that I think the corporate sector of IT industry, like Infosys, TCS, the software company is open to all. It's not mean that if you are belongs to electrical engineer, you are not eligible for the computer science job. Computer science is open to all. So maybe in future, the interest will come regarding a software industry. So for that, you have to learn all the programming language, C++, Java and Python. It will be better for you to create a multiple option in the career. If you want to work on the electrical engineering only, so for that, some different programmings are also available, like PLC, I think. PLC, I have no more idea regarding the electrical engineer. But as a PLC programmer, if you want to work there, so for that, C, C++. If you want to work with embedded system, if you want to work with IoT mechanism, Internet of Things mechanism, so for that, minimum C, C++ skills are required. After that, you can go for the PLC, or you can go for the embedded system, or you can go for the VLSI, or you can go for the robotics application, or you can go for the IoT applications. So for that, minimum C, C++ skills are required. But if you want to create more options in your career, so for that, you can go for the Java and Python also. Right? Yes. Because with the help of Java and Python also, you can implement the robotics application. You can implement the IoT-based applications. All right? Yes. I'm expecting what the question you watched. I given the proper response on that basis also. All right? Okay. So as for the discussion, what we implemented up to 8, man, please focus. Sir, what are the programming languages are available in this list? We know that operating system is not a programming language. Database is not a programming language. Data structure is not a programming language. So as a programming language, four programming language knowledge are compulsory required. One is C, C++, Java, and Python. Please focus. I know you are very much nearer to this computer science terminology. So for that, in a basic manner, first I am targeting some objective. After that, we will go for some advanced discussion also. So first, we have to focus on these four programming language. We have to identify which one is the best one and where that programming language we can consider as the best. Listen carefully. In the very first, I'm implementing small program. I'm implementing small program that may be easy to understand to you in C, C++, Java, and Python. Listen carefully. The first step of learning, the first step of learning, you have to remember many things, man. The first step of learning, you have to remember many things. If you will remember that things in today, then only you are eligible to understand that concept in future. The first step of learning, we have to remember many things. If you are remembering that concept today, then only you are eligible to understand that concept in future. In the first attempt, in the first attempt, nobody in this world can understand all that things. Slowly. It's a long process. Learning is a long process. It's not a one-night process. Right? Yes. I think you know better. Later, I am implementing a C program. Just to focus, man. Not required to take more serious in this discussion. This is only introductory class. I want to implement a C program. To implement a C program, we have to provide some extension. This is called extension. Some different terminology we have to acquaint it. Extension dot C is the extension. Men is the file name. It may be X, it may be Y, it may be Z, but to implement a C program, dot C extension is required compulsory. Very simple, sir. The first step of learning, we have to remember many things. Sir, what to remember? This is a program you have to remember. Stdio.h. In main, in C, first include the header file. Next, implement the main function. Inside the main function to print something. Just take the help of the predefined function. Predefined a library function, printf, and hello world. That's all. Once this program is written, once this program is written, we have to compile the program. the things what you have to remember in this process, man. Let's focus. I will focus on that things what is required to remember. To implement a C program, the extension is required.c. Extension is required.c. To compile a C program, we have to use GCC, GCC compiler. Terminology, sir, extension.c, compiler, GCC. Is that clear? Yes, sir. Once the program is successfully compiled, once the program is successfully compiled, one file is created. Which file is created, sir? .out file is created. This .out file, we can say, this is our machine code. Listen carefully. I told you the first step of learning, we have to remember some terminology. Sir, extension.c, compiler, GCC, main.c, source code, a.out, machine code, .out, machine code. Sir, can I execute the .out file? Yes, sir. This is the way to execute the machine code, ./a.out. So these are the commands you have to practice. After that, you can remember that one. But the minimum things, what we can remember here, extension in C, .c. GCC is the C compiler. Main.c is our source code. .out is our machine code. This is terminology we have to remember. Yes, sir. We know that, sir. Four programming language skills are compulsory required. C, then C++, then Java, then Python. I'm just giving an introduction to all four programming language. Sir, we got some idea in C, what the things we have to implement there. Has include main, printf. It's required very few practice. After that, you will be master also. Sir, next, I want to implement some program in C++. Listen carefully, man. C++, file name, dot extension. To implement a C++ program, the extension will be applicable, dot cpp. CPP stands for C++. For a C program, dot C extension. For C++ program, dot CPP extension. It's very easy, not required to repeat, I think. Sir, how to implement a C++ program? Very easy. You have to remember now. Sir, has include iostream using namespace std. What is the meaning of this statement? This is not the right time to explain, man. First step, you have to remember this statement. In future, you can get the clear visualization, sir. What is the working mechanism of this statement? Yes, sir. Main function. Inside the main function, we have to provide the print statement, cout, provide the message, hello world, and take a slash. Any message you can provide here, man. And this slash is taken for the new line, next line. New line, simple. We don't know what is iostream. We don't know what is using, what is namespace, what is std, what is cout. Cout is not a function. Cout is not a class. Cout is not a function. Cout is not a variable. Cout is not a keyword. What is that cout, man? We don't know. We don't know, sir. Cout is nothing but it's an object. Many depth knowledge is available. Forget about that now. Sir, once the program is written, once the program is written, what to do? Compilation we have to do. Sir, which compiler we used previously? GCC compiler. But GCC compiler is not applicable for C++ program. Dekhiye, I am going to get some error. I am going to get some error. GCC is not able to understand. GCC is not able to understand what is a cout. GCC is not able to understand what is a C++ instructions. Sir, so for that, which compiler is required? G++ compiler is required. Okay. Again, .out file is generated. That's our bus in code. If I will execute my bus in code, I am getting hello world message. This hello world message I am not getting from C. This hello world message I am getting with the programming skills of C++. So we know four programming skills are compulsory required: C, C++, Java, and Python. At least, sir, we got involved. We are not master in C. We are not master in C++. But sir, at least we involved in the first program of C, first program of C++. Like that, we have to get some involvement with the Java process, with the Python process. Listen carefully, man. Sir, what are the things we have to remember in this discussion? For C++ program, the extension is required on CPP. Remember, I will cross check. I will ask some doubt on that basis also. Right? Yes, sir. Dot CPP is the extension. Compiler for C++, G++. Are you getting that statement? Dot C, C source code. Dot CPP, C++ source code. Dot out is our machine code here. Listen carefully. Next, sir, next programming language we have to focus, that's our Java. The very first program we have to remember only. We have to remember. If you will remember in present, then only you are eligible to understand the concept in future. Neither, no. Is that clear? Very simple thing. Only 3-4 lines will come. It's not very complicated to remember that. Sir, what to do in Java? Class demo. We don't know what is class. But it's okay. Just remember, class demo, that public, static, void, main, compulsory required, not optional, compulsory required string args. It's an array. So to print something in Java, it's a complicated task. What to do? System dot out dot print ln. Provide the message hello world, I am Java. Any message you can provide. Any message you can provide. Hello world, I am Java. Sir, once this program is implemented, that's all. This much we have to write in Java in the very first program. Once the program is written, now the time came for the compilation. Yes or no, man? I think you remembered these steps. For C, which compiler we used? GCC compiler. For C++ compilation, G++ compiler. Like that. For the Java compilation, we have to use Java C compiler. What is my source code? Demo.java. Listen carefully. Sir, is there any error in my process? No. In my program, is there any error? No. If any error, compiler will inform regarding that error. Are you getting that statement? Yes, sir. I got the clear visualization what to do in Java, how to compile in Java. After compilation, one file is generated, demo.java, demo.class is generated after the compilation process. Simple. Try to remember this process. Sir, how to execute this program? Java demo, that's all. Java demo, I am getting my output, hello world, I am Java. Sir, up to yet, we don't know C, up to yet, we don't know C++, it's okay, man. Up to yet, we don't know Java, but sir, we are trying our best to involve in the program of C, C++ and Java. The first process is something complicated, man. It's very much painful because without understanding, you have to remember many things. And when you will get the clear visualization, at that time your pressure will be released. Not required to worry. We have sufficient time on that to understand the concept. So, if I will go for my manual, we know that four programming skills are compulsory required: C, C++, Java. The last programming skills of what we listed as for our knowledge, Python. Please focus here. To implement a C program, dot C extension is required. Extension, dot C. To implement a C++ program, dot cpp extension, simple. To implement a Java program, dot a Java extension, like that. To implement a Python program, dot a Python extension, it's required. But one mistake we did here. This is not valid. This is wrong. Sir, then what is the right? In Java, we have to specify dot a Java. But in Python, it's not required to specify dot a Python. We have to specify only dot a py. Py. Py stands for Python. The first two characters. Sir, how to implement it? How to implement the very first program in Python? Print, print, hello world. Print, print, hello world, I am Python. Print, hello world, I am Python. That's all. That's all. Program is completed. Sir, now the time came for the execution. Now the time came for the execution. What to do? Python test.py. That's all. Python test.py. Sir, finally. Successfully, I am getting the output as per the instruction I specified in my program. Some different terminology. You have to be acquainted with this terminology. Sir, finally, I am getting the response. I am getting the success result as per the instruction I specified in my source code of a Python program. Are you getting that statement? Yes, sir. I'm expecting at least, maybe you are not clear in C, maybe we don't know C++, maybe we don't know Java, maybe we don't know the Python mechanism, but sir, we just engaged, we just involved in the implementation process of a C program, C++ program, Java program and Python program. Dekhiye, sir, same objective, same, very, very small objective, man. Common objective. Small objective we targeted in C, same objective we targeted in C++, same objective we targeted in Java, same objective we implemented in Python. See, given the solution, C++ given the solution, Java given the solutions, and for the same objective Python given the solution. So it's not required to ask you, man, which one is the best solution in between these four programming language. Can you please give some response? Which solution is impressing you, man? Maybe we don't know regarding the implementations. We don't know regarding the concept, but at least we can predict, we can identify which solution is impressing you. The C solution is impressing you. Or C++ solution is impressing you, or Java solution is impressing you, or Python solution is impressing you. It's very easy to identify, man. It's very easy to identify. Sir, one of the best programming language I got from this discussion, that's our Python. This is sufficient enough to understand why Python is on the demand. Why Python is on the demand, not required to worry like that. I will implement many programs in front of you if the time will support us. In this way, I can give many programs, 100, 200, 500 programs I can implement in front of you. But for that, more time is required. And after writing 500 programs in Python, 500 programs in C, C++, Java and Python, definitely, man, your all the concept will be clear. This should be the approach. Listen carefully, my sir. From this process, we got the clear visualization, how the code is going to be organized, how the code is going to be looks like, how the code is going to be implemented. Some basics ideas. We are not master, but we have some idea how the code is going to be represented, how the code is going to be looks like in C, C++, Java, and Python. We know which one is the best solution, man. But now if I will ask you, which solution is the most complicated solution? Can you please give some response? Just look to the code. Just look to the approach. Try to give me some response, man. Which solution is the most complicated solution? I think you can predict that one very easily. Which solution is looking like something more complicated, man? डेफिनेटली मैम, दैट वॉज एक्सपेक्टिंग सर जावा सर्विस. देखिए ना सर, हेलो वर्ल्ड प्रिंट करना है, मुझे पहला स्टडी करना होगा. फर्स्ट आई हैव टू स्टडी व्हाट इज क्लास, देन आई हैव टू स्टडी व्हाट इज पब्लिक, व्हाट इज स्टैटिक, व्हाट इज वर्ड, व्हाट इज मैन, व्हाट इज स्ट्रिंग, व्हाट इज आर्ग्स, व्हाट इज अरे, व्हाट इज सिस्टम, व्हाट इज आउट, व्हाट इज प्रिंट. आफ्टर दैट आई एम एलिजिबल. After that, I am eligible to implement a Hello World program only. After that, I am eligible to implement a Hello World program. How much concept you have to do? But in Python, we can implement this kind of program also, man. In Python, we can implement this kind of program also. In Python, we can implement the simplified program also. In many ways, for the same objective, we can implement many ways in Python. It depends on you what the approach you want to implement in Python. There, Python is ready to provide any kinds of solution, complicated solution. Also, it's ready to provide the easiest solutions to you. It depends on you what the solution you want to implement in Python. So, as per that, Python is one of the most versatile, most important, one of the best programming language considered as per the today's scenario. Maybe. I don't know after 5 years, after 10 years, what will be the scenario. But up to today situation, Python one of the most demanded concept in the market. It's very easy to understand, very easy to implement. Yes, sir. Listen carefully, man. That's not mean that in Python nothing is there. Maximum students are telling that Python is easy. Yes, man. I am also telling Python is easy. Python is easy. Python is very easy, but that's not mean that in Python nothing is there. Listen carefully. All the concept of C, all the concept of C++, all the concept of Java is available in Python. Python having the concept like C, like C++, like Java, all the concept you are going to learn in Python. Python is easy. But that's not mean that Python have no any concept. Python have all the concept like C, C++, Java with more advanced concept. What the concept is available in Python, that's not available in Java also. But what the concept is available in Java, all the concepts are available in Python. Are you getting that statement? Are you getting that statement? Yes, sir. Python is easy, man. But Python have all the concepts also. So then why you were telling Python is easy? Because in Python, the syntax is very clean. The syntax is very small. It's not providing the complicated syntax. It's not providing the complicated syntax like Java. Concept itself, but the syntax is very easy. On the point of view of syntax, Python is easy. On the point of view of concept, in Python, all the concepts are available like C, C++, Java also. Listen carefully, man. Now the time came, sir. Can you please confirm what the concepts are available in Python? What the concepts are available in Python? Core Python concept is available. Object oriented programming structure concept is also available. Advanced Python concept is also available. Please focus. I am just providing the content here. Sir, in core Python, what the concepts are available? What the chapters are available? Introduction chapter. Next, operators chapter. Next, data types. Next, memory management mechanism, control structure, control statement, function, module, package. File handling, command line argument, and exception handling mechanism. I think the wordings, this terminology, already we got some idea in the previous class of C. In C also, these are the chapters are available: operators chapter, data types chapter, file handling chapter, command line chapter. It's also available in C, in C++, in Java also. We are going to learn in Python also. Sir, in object oriented programming structure, what the concept we have to deal? We have to deal regarding class and object. Then we have to focus on data member, method, then constructor, destructor, garbage collector. Many concepts are available. Garbage collector, operator overloading, type conversion, relation, association, aggregation. Most important concept, man. Association, aggregation, polymorphism, then abstraction, then access specifier mechanism. These concepts are available in C++. These concepts are available in Java. These concepts are also available in Python. I told you the core concept we collected from C. The object oriented concept we know from C++, from Java. In advanced Python, what the concept we have to deal? We have to deal regarding multiprocessing. We have to deal regarding multi-threading. We have to deal regarding multiprocessing, multi-threading. We have to deal regarding signals. We have to deal regarding socket programming or networking. We have to get some idea regarding the database handling mechanism. Here, SQL database we will study. MongoDB we have to study here. One is structured, another is non-structured. And SQL based on structure, Mongo having no structure, no SQL database. We don't know what is structure oriented and what is non-structure oriented. After that, we have to focus on the data visualization mechanism. After that, we have to implement CLED graphical user interface, GUI mechanism. After that, we have to target some framework having the name Django. Django framework, the most popular framework. The most popular framework of Python is called Django. It's used for web-based applications to create some website. So this is the content we are going to provide in our organization. I am providing this content of complete Python. I divided the Python in three different segments: core Python, object-oriented programming structure using Python, and advanced Python methods. I'm expecting this discussion, this process, this analysis is very much clear to all of you. At least from this discussion, we got the idea. Sir, C code, C++ code, Java code, and Python code. Which code is best? We got the idea, sir, definitely Python is best. Python is easy. That's not mean Python have no any concept. In Python, what are the concepts are available? All the concepts I listed in front of you also. These are the concepts are available in Python. C concepts are available. C++, Java concepts are available. And Python concepts are also available. Are you getting that statement? That's not mean that in Python, no any concept. In Python, all the concepts are available with more advanced concept. I'm expecting up to it, whatever the discussion we implemented in front of you, all these discussions are very much clear to all of you. So can you please give some response? Is that discussion is clear to all of you? If any doubts up to it you have, then you can share with me. If no doubts, give some confirmation. After that, we will move forward. Your confirmation report for me. After that, We will move forward here. Is that discussion is clear to all of you? I thought to execute a different kinds of content in front of you, but I modified the content because your seniors informed me regarding your status, that you are fresher now, not having more knowledge on the different programming language, neither we can implement some different kind of objective there to identify the power of Python here, right? Acha, can you please confirm that? I'm just asking you. I'm going to collect very few objective in front of you. In a basic way, I targeted many objective, but as you are fresher, I have to filter some objective, what you can understand. So can you target some objective with the knowledge of Python? We don't have regarding that, but at least you can get some involved to identify, sir, how Python is best if I will compare the Python with Java or any other programming language, right? Yes. So listen carefully, going to target some objective in Python there. Very, very small objective we will target there. Dekhiye, very small objective, man. I'm not going for the complicated objective. Very, very small objective I will implement in a normal approach, standard approach. After that, I will implement with the efficient approach with the help of Python. Right? Very simple objective. Find the factors of a number. Please focus here. Find the factors of a number. I think you are very much master on that. What the output is expected, sir? If I will enter 12. What the factors are expected? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. It's very easy to identify. We know, sir, if a number is completely dividing my numbers, we can say that number is a factor of our number. Is or not? It's a very simple thing, man. Find the factors of a number. Sir, what is the standard logic for this objective? Going for the standard approach. After that, I will target the efficient approach. Please focus here, man. Sir, how to implement this kind of objective? Let's going for C. We don't know C skill. Forget about the syntax. Only focus on the objective. Sir, I have a number. I have a number. What is the number, man? Let 12. Sir, I want to find out the factors. Factors. Are you getting that statement? Yes, sir. I want to find the factors of a dedicated number. Well, what I will do? For try to involve for I is equal to 1, I smaller than equal to 12, each time I plus plus. Sir, just print what is the value of I. Please focus here, but very simple. Percentile D, take a slash n, what is the value of I? Forget about the syntax, man. This is not the right time to focus on the syntax. This is the time to focus on the logic only. Forget about the syntax here. Sir, let I is a variable. If I will compile the program, up to yet my logic is not completed. If I will run, sir, what the output I am getting? From 1 up to that number, I am getting all the numbers increased by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Are you getting that statement? Yes, sir. No any problem. We got the clear visualization up to it, what the logic is implemented, what is the meaning of that objective here? What is the meaning of this logic? What it's doing? If I will change this number, let the number is not 12, let the number is 5, then what the output will come? If I will compile and if I will run, sir, 1 to that number, it's moving up to that. 1 to 5, all the numbers are collected. If I will provide later, the number is 15, what I will do? What my program will do? Sir, if I will compile, run, sir, 1 to 15, all the numbers are selected. All the numbers are selected. Listen carefully. All the numbers what I got are not the factors. Sir, which will be considered as a factor? for that some specific condition is required. So if number modulo I, this modulo operator is used to find out the remainder. This is not operator. This is the operator to calculate the remainder of the division. If the remainder is equal to zero, if the remainder is equal to zero, then we can consider then we can consider this I as a factor. That's all. If the remainder is zero, then we can consider this I as a factor. Forget about the syntax. Syntax will come with practice. Logic you have to focus on. If I will run, there is no problem. If I will run, sorry, in 15, for 15, what are the factors are there? 1, 3, 5, 15. Beautiful. Beautiful, sir. My task is completed. Let the number is given 12. Sir, what are the factors of 12? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. If I will run this program, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. That's all. My logic is implemented to find the factors of a specific number with the help of a C programming language. Sir, logic is very much clear to all of you. Forget about the syntax. Next up, again, I'm going for the Python objective. In Python, listen carefully. In Python, there is a predefined function is available, range. In Python, there is a predefined function is available, range. If I will provide, sir, मुझे एक से लेके पांच के बीच में कुछ numbers चाहिए. I want to get the range from 1 to 5. I want to get the range from 1 to 5. Listen carefully. I want to get the range from 1 to 5. It's telling. Sir, what are the numbers will be selected? 1, 2, 3, 4. The important thing what you have to focus. 5 is not included. 5 is not included. Sir, I want to take this 5 in this list. What should I do? I have to provide 5 plus 1, 6. If I will provide 6, it will move up to 5. Are you getting that statement? Initial value 1, stop value 5. If a 5 will be given, up to 4 it will move. If a 6 will be given, up to 5 it will move. Yes, sir, we got the clear visualization. Sir, same thing is required now. Dekhiye, going for the efficient objective. Sir, I want to print a collection. We don't know what is this bracket. Try to involve only. I want to print a collection. In this collection, I want to consider some value. Value available in range. What the value you are expecting, man? What the value you are expecting from 1, 2, number plus 1. 1, 2, number plus 1. What it means, sir? Number is 12. 1, 2, 13. 1, 2, 13. What are the numbers will be selected, man? 1, 2, 13. Sir, up to 1 to 12 numbers will be selected. 1 to 12 value will be selected. Listen carefully. Sir, is that going to happen properly? Why not, man? If I will run, dekhiye, once leke 12 tak mujhe har ek element mil gaya hai. Sir, up to 1 to 12, up to 1 to 12, I got all the individual elements. I got individual values. But all the values are not factors. Sir, yahan pe jo bhi value available hai, all the values are not the factors. What is the criteria to be a factor? What is the criteria to be a factor? If a number division with a value, if the number division with the value remainder is zero, if I will divide that value with a number, if the remainder will be zero, we can consider that value. We can consider that value as a factor. That's all. Python is targeted the logic man. If I will run Python test.py, sir, what is the factors of 12? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. What are the factors of 12? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. But difference is what here? For the same objective, in C, near about how many lines of code we implemented? Near about 10 lines of code we implemented. But in Python, only one line of logic. Listen carefully. Instead of the first line, we can ask to the user, sir, enter a number. Asking to the user also, enter a number. Whatever the number you will provide, as per that, I will find out the factors. If I will run, sir, 12 factors, some spelling mistake I'm getting here. What the mistake? Yes, sir. Some variable is also used. So for that, we have to take that variable. Number variable is required. Sir, what is this number? Asking to the user at runtime. This is the way. Talks to the user regarding the value at runtime. Input. This is which kind of input is required? Number kind of input, integer kind of input. So, asks to the user, enter a number. After getting that number, it's a which kind of number? Integer kind of number stored in my variable. Again, if I will run this objective, let's cross check my objective is target or not. Python 3 or Python test.py providing 12. Sir, what are the factors of 12? 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 12. If I will enter 5, sir, 1 and 5. If I will enter 15, 1, 3, 5 and 15. Wow, beautiful, sir. Same objective in C, this much number of lines. Same objective in Python, this much number of lines. I am expecting this is again proved. Which programming language is providing the efficient solution? So can you please give some response, man? Which solution is impressing you here? Which programming approach is impressing you? I targeted the same objective in C, C++. I think you know, if you know C, same program is required in C++, same program is required in Java, having few syntax difference. Definitely, sir, in this objective, our Python is winning this game. Listen carefully, man. Going for some next objective. Dekhiye, very few objective I will try to implement in front of you. Try to involve in this process. What the next objective? Very small objective. Very, very small objective. Sir, I want to print some pattern program. 1 star, 2 star, 3 star, 4 star, and 5 star. This much. Sir, mujhe ye pattern program ko implement karna hai. Sir, what to do on that basis? How to target this logic? Listen carefully, man. Logic having important role. In this objective, we have to focus on row and column mechanism. Row and column. How many rows are available? First row, second row, third row, fourth row, and fifth row. Dekhiye, what to do for this objective, sir? That I'm choosing C language. What to do? Us include, forget about the syntax, man. stdio.h. Next is our main function. Inside the main function, first I have to handle the row, then we have to handle the column. What to do? Sir, row is 1. How many rows are required? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 rows are required. So what to do? Row is smaller than 6. Row is smaller than 6. 1 to 6 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many rows will come? five rows will come. Listen carefully. Each time row plus plus. Start from one, move up to six, increase one. Start from one, move up to six, increase one. Sir, properly, row is handled. Then we have to focus. We have to handle the column. Column zero, column one, column two, column three, and column four. It's required few practice. For column is a zero, column is less than row, column plus plus. That's much number of time. What we have to do? We have to print the star. We have to print a star for each row. For each row, we have to take a new line. Listen carefully. For each row, not for column. For each column, new line is not required. For each row, new line is required. First row, take a new line. Second row, take the next line. Third row, take the next line. Fourth row, take the next line. Fifth row, the process will be completed. That's all. Our logic is targeted successfully. If I will compile, if I will run, beautiful, sir. Our star pattern logic is successfully completed. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now this is your turn, man. Listen carefully. I'm going to ask some questions regarding the previous experiment what we did. I want to generate a collection 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. For this, which function I should call in Python? Range. Can you please confirm what is the initial value? What is the start value I should provide? And what is the stop value I should provide in this range? I think you can give this response now, man. What the start value I should provide? What the stop value I should provide in range to generate this sequence? To generate this collection, to generate this sequence, can you please give some response in this range? What the start parameter? What the stop parameter I should specify? Let I'm going to you to identify your status. Beautiful, man. Not 1 to 5. Not 1 to 5. If I will provide 5, it will move up to 4. If I will provide 5, it will move up to 4. What we have to specify? 1 to 6. 1 to 6. After that, it will work. Listen carefully. If you are telling, sir, range 1, 5, what it will do? It will move up to 1 to 4. Stop will be not included. For that, we have to specify 6. After that, 1 to 5 is included. This is the first trick. Listen carefully. Next trick. In Python, if you have a string, in Python, if you have a string, hi, it's a string. Hello, it's a string. If I will multiply that string with a 3, with a number, in Python, if I will multiply a string with a number, what it will do? It will repeat that string for that specific number of time. What will happen? Hi, it is generated. Sir, if you want to repeat a particular string for a specific number of time in Python, we can multiply that string with a number. Listen carefully. Sir, I have to target that objective. Pattern program, one star, after that two star, after that we have to provide 3 star, after that we have to provide 4 star, after that we have to provide 5 star. Pattern program in Python, what to do? Very simple, man. Dekhiye, sir, in range 1 to 6, I want to get the number for number available in this range. what it will do? Sir, it will target all the number in that range. Sir, 1 to 5, 1 to 5, 4. All the numbers are targeted. Listen carefully, man. 1 to 5, 4. All the numbers are targeted. Sir, if I will provide, I'm just asking to the user. I'm not giving a hard-coded value. Asking to the user. We know how to ask to the user. Input. Enter a number. Enter n value. N value. If I will run, if I will provide 6, the last value will come 5. If I will provide 11, the last value will come 10. If I will provide 21, the last value will come 20. Reason we know, man. Not required to worry. Sir, next what we have to do, if I am running providing 6, what it's doing, man? It's generating some numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What I will do now, sir, star into 1, one star will come. Star into 2, two star will come. Star into 3, three star will come. Star into 4, four star will come. Star into 5, five star will come. String repetition. Like a star into 5. 5 times star is repeated. Star into 4. 4 times star is repeated. Star into 3 times star is repeated. Same thing we have to do. Listen carefully. Whatever the number you taken, don't take that number. Multiply that number with my star. If a number is 1, star into 1, 1 times star will come. If a number is 2, star into 2, 2 times star will come. If a number is 3, star into 3, 3 times star will come. Do you want to cross check? Yes, sir. Very interested for this objective. If I will enter 6, what is happening, man? Instead of a 1, 1 star. Instead of a 5, star into 5, 5 star. But sir, activate my pyramid pattern. My star pattern is not properly implemented. Values are generated, but not properly represented, not properly printed. Very simple. What to do? We have to join first string, second string, third string, fourth string, fifth string, first element, second element, third element, fourth element, fifth element. We have to join using new lines, using new lines. Join using /n/n for new lines. We know this objective. What we have to do, sir? Very simple. I will give the instruction, sir. By using new line, by using /n, join the elements available inside this list. That's all. If I will run this program, Python s.py, providing 6, my star pattern is generated. Beautiful, sir. Providing 11, star pattern is generated. Providing 21, star pattern is generated. Same objective I implemented in C++ Java. Same syntax will work in Java. Only the previous first statement will be different, but the logic, this row column logic will be same in Java, man. Will be same in Java also. Same objective we implemented in Java. Same objective we implemented in Python. Dekhiye, in Java this much number of lines. In Python this much number of lines. Only one line is sufficient enough. In Python, one line is sufficient enough to implement this kind of beautiful objective. One line is sufficient enough in Python to target this kind of objective there. I'm expecting this discussion is very much clear to all of them. Maybe we have not sufficient knowledge to understand this kind of logic. We are not here to understand the logic. We are just here to identify what is the power of Python. Why Python is more demand on this Python, man? on this market here. Why Python is more demanded on this market? This is the reason only. But this is looking like very simple, but to implement this kind of a language, this kind of syntax, for that more practice is required. After that, you can also implement this kind of objective in one line also. I'm expecting this is very much clear to all of you. So can you please give some response? Which programming language, again, it's impressing you? Which programming language is impressing you, man? The Java approach or the Python approach? Which solution, which programming approach is impressing you, sir, without any doubts? Without any doubts, we can say, sir, Python, one of the best programming languages there. I'm expecting up to it. All these discussions are very much clear to all of mine. So can you please give some response? Are you comfortable with this discussion? Are you comfortable with this kind of discussions, man? Maybe we are not able to understand a single word, but sir, we are able to visualize what is the power of Python, how to implement a C program, how to implement a Java program, how the program is going to looks like in C, how the program is going to looks like in Python. At an introductory level, at a basic level, if you are able to visualize that one, then it's okay. After doing more practice, you can implement this kind of objective also. Right? Yes. In this way, we can target many different objectives. We can target many different objectives, right? Yes. But for that minimum C knowledge, agar aapke paas C ka knowledge hota, we can target many objective like this. Near about 20, 30, 50, 100 programs in 10, 20 lines. I will target in C++, Java. Same program I will target in Python in one line. How much beautiful that will be. But still, for that proper knowledge, basic knowledge is required in C, C++, and Java. After that also, you can enjoy this kind of session. Right? Yes. So I'm expecting for today, this much discussion will be sufficient for you, man. So what are the status? Should I move forward or the saturation point? I don't want to create the overheadings to you, man. So who are the organizer? So should we move forward? What are the status, man? What are the time limit you have?
Yes, sir. That's 2 hours. So currently it has been 1 hour 51 minutes. So I guess that would be quite a
overheadings, right?
Yes, sir. Right.
So thank you for your patience, for your time, for your support, for your love, for everything what you've given to me. I have only one word to say, it's thank you, and have a great day, man, and have a great career in software like the okay.
Thanks a lot, sir, for demonstrating how Python is quite effective in comparison to other languages. That was really great, sir. And we are quite lucky to have you, sir. So we are looking forward for some future collaborations, like future workshops. So thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir.
Whenever you will need me, I will be with you, man, for your team. For your team, right? What are the team name you have?
Cyborg, sir.
Right. So whenever you will need me, just make a call to us. We will be available with you. Our team will be available with you.
That's so kind of you. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.